When you do this role, you are going to have the potential to be involved and make a difference in absolutely the worst moment of somebody's life. Even though the ER is fairly autonomous, when you're in the back of the aircraft, it's you. It's you and your partner. We have a set of guidelines that we follow. We have great medical direction that we follow, but really that responsibility is 100% on you without having that backup of a physician and a whole other handful of staff to help out. My name is Renee Delau. I'm a flight nurse and flight paramedic for LifeMed of Michigan. I started out my career as a paramedic, knew that I kind of always wanted to be a flight nurse. That's why I started out as a paramedic. Emergency medicine was always my love. So I went to nursing school after that, maintained both certifications. Worked emergency department for probably 15 years. Started doing ground critical care transport in 2008. Joined the Air Methods program in Lansing, which was also a LifeNet program, and became a flight nurse. This is one of the jobs where you always have to be on it. The education here is amazing. Our training is amazing. I don't ever feel bored because there's always something to learn and there's always something to study. The 24-hour shifts have their pros and cons. I mean, we work 2 days a week, so that kind of gives you an opportunity to go to school, to work other jobs, to kind of have a little bit of extra time. And I kind of feel like when I was at Michigan State, all of the faculty that I worked with was like, you know, you can do anything you want. You know, you can pick any line of nursing with your bachelor's degree. You can go on to your master's, you can go on to your doctorate. You can do NP, that there's really not a limitation to what you can do as a nurse. And that was one of the reasons why I chose Michigan State. I think they just have a really good reputation for that. The majority of our volume is inter-facility transfer, so hospital to hospital. So whether it's ICU to ICU or emergency department in a small rural like critical access hospital to a larger hospital, the majority of the time it's the sickest of the sick. They may appear stable, but whatever their diagnosis is, time is of the essence in getting them from wherever they are to definitive care. Whether it's stroke, whether it's heart attack that are truly time dependent, or whether it's trauma where they need a trauma surgeon. I kind of feel like you have so much responsibility on you, and I feel like even all of these years in, I don't really think there's a time that the radio doesn't go off that I don't get a little twinge of nervousness.